this video of the Master Budget series, we're going to be discussing specifically the cash budget. And I just want to remind you that the lecture notes that are used in these videos are available on my website at theaccountingdoctor.com. So in previous videos, we've already talked about the sales budget and how that is the cornerstone of the master budget, and all budgets lead from there. We've also discussed the inventory, purchases, and cost of goods sold budget in previous videos. So to demonstrate the cash budget, let's start with a cash T account. We know that cash, being an asset, carries a debit balance. So we'll have our beginning and ending balances there. Any payments made in cash would, of course, be credited to our cash T account. And if we borrow money or collect money from customers, that would make our cash account go up. So each part of this T account we have here actually would have its own budget. And we want to start with the collections. So cash collections, that's what we're going to look at in this first example here. So in a prior video, we talked about Gripper's sales budget. So if you have viewed that video, please take a look at that budget now. If not, I'm going to show you the completed Gripper's budget on the screen. And we're going to assume that Gripper's sales are actually 25% cash and 75% on credit. Gripper's collection history indicates that credit sales are as follows. We're going to collect 30% of credit sales in the month of the sale, 60% the month after the sale, and 6% 2 months after the sale, and 4% will never be collected. Then they tell us that November sales totaled $391,500 and December sales were $398,250. We need to prepare a schedule for the budgeted cash collections for the months of January and February. So let's start with January. We know that if we make cash sales, we're going to collect those cash sales immediately. So again, remember, we are specifically looking at cash collections for January. So January's cash sales will obviously be collected in the month of January. So we're going to include those in our schedule here. So we have January's cash sales. Sales in January were $740,000. And that, again, came from our sales budget. And 25% of them, or 25% of that total, is for cash. So that equals $185,000 in cash sales for January that would be collected in January. Now we've got to look at the credit sales from January. So since we're in the month of January, 30% from our collection schedule up there is going to be collected in the month of sale. So therefore, 30% of credit sales will equal $166,500. Now remember, we're not looking at the total $740,000 in sales. We're only interested in collecting the credit sales at this point. So credit sales are 75% of total sales. So $740,000 being my total sales times 75% would give me my total credit sales in January. And I'm only going budgeting to collect 30% of that in the month of the sale. Now we can move to the month prior, which was December, because we're going to collect some of December's credit sales in the month of January. Specifically, we're going to collect 60% of December's credit sales in the month of January. So if we take the December sales of $398,250 times 75%, which is what we budget to be our credited amount of sales, times 60% gives me $179,213 from December's credit sales that we plan to collect in January. We also plan to collect 6 months, or 6% of sales from 2 months ago, which would be November. So credit sales, or total sales in November, were $391,500. Again, we plan, or we budget that 75% of total sales will be credit sales. And we plan that only 6% will be collected 2 months after the sale, giving us $17,618 that will be collected in January from November sales, giving us total cash collections for the month of January to be $548,331. So what I'd like for you to do now is push pause on your player and see if you can come up with the total cash collections for February. And then we'll come back and take a look at it together. Now that you've completed the cash collections for February, let's see how you did. You should have found that the cash collections for the month of February would equal $716,671. This came from the total collections from the month of February, which we know we're going to collect all of our cash sales from February in the month of February. In addition, we're going to collect 30% of credit sales from February. We're also going to collect 60% of the credit sales from January and 6% of the credit sales from December. Again, that's giving us $716,671.